broadcasting from the cool confines of the Sycamore Room at the Norman B. Murray Community Center in beautiful Mission Viejo, it's Breakfast with Gary and Kelly with special guest Cadillac Slim himself, Mr. Rick Braun.
I know you do. There is a little of that. Thanks very much, everybody. Welcome to Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. We're great, thrilled to have you here, and we're happy to be here. We're happy, really, we're happy to be anywhere.
We're happy.
Exactly. We're
the
just happy.
Good.
That's very true. Yeah. Have you guys been having fun this morning? This is pretty good, isn't it?
A good one?
Pretty good morning.
I would just like to say a thank you to Gary, because when he told me what he was going to be doing, I kind of went,
Once again, she didn't get it.
I had no idea. And I said, you know what? I'm just going to let you take off and do your thing. So I commend you for a wonderful job.
Oh, thank you very much.
And you were right.
We had fun. You
got that on tape.
Yeah, it's good stuff. It's a special morning. This is about to get a lot better.
Yes.
A lot better. This is CD number 16 for this gentleman. And it has been out now all of about 4 days.
Yep. It took him 5 years, though.
It took him 4 days to get to number one.
Yeah!
It is number one right now.
And
he's on the cover of Smooth Jazz News.
Smooth Jazz News cover.
We are, he's become a great friend. He was at the birthday bash again this year, has been at the bash the last few years. Second time on this show. We're thrilled to tell you he's back. Please say hello to Rick Braun.
Love the shades. Kelly. Woo!
Ah!
Double!
Exactly. Exactly. Are you two done over there?
We're having a moment.
I mean, just look at the glasses. Seriously.
I know.
Take a close up of his glasses.
You're kind of going for that California Highway Patrol look,
it
huh?
Is.
No. Well, a man in a uniform, you know. Yeah, but I was thinking more Mission Impossible, 007, oh, okay. Mystery Man.
See, I picked up on Eric Estrada. I don't know. Maybe it's just my influences, I suppose. Oh, man.
You know what? I don't even need to say anything. You guys are so entertaining. I can just sit here and enjoy.
Well, I think he looks hot. Good lady.
Well, he does. Yeah, baby. Exactly.
Okay.
Thanks for being here, man.
Oh, gosh.
Great to see you.
It's a pleasure. It's always a pleasure.
Sitting
Thank you, Gary.
Sitting here talking to number one in the land, baby. How fun is that?
After 4 days?
Isn't that great?
Yeah, it debuted number one on iTunes
and
Amazon, so I've had the number one CD in the country for the last 4 days, which is...
Woo! Now that's even hotter!
It really is.
Wow, that's really cool.
It really
amazing,
is.
Amazing. Congratulations.
Thank you. But thank you to everybody for buying the CD. It's absolutely so wonderful. I cannot thank you enough for your support. I mean, it is my 16th CD. You'd think they'd be tired of me by this point.
I don't think so. Happy
well, if you want to do that, we'll roast you if you want to sign up.
Oh, that would be fun.
Yeah.
You guys did a great job on that. You did a great job on that.
Oh my God. Talk about this thing. How long in the making?
This CD took a long time. It's over a year in the making. And one of the reasons is I've been traveling so much. And so I'd go in and out of town and I'd start a song and come back in town and it'd take me a minute to remember where I was, because it's a little harder to remember things now than it used to be. On my first CD, I could keep track of everything.
I remember that, Dave.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
Yeah, right.
So, you know, I'd go in and out of town. But the other thing is I really was, I must have written about 18 or 19 songs for this. And, of course, there's 11 songs on there. And I wanted to be really particular about this CD. It's been a while since I've released a contemporary jazz record. And I wanted it to be special. And I also wanted it to have that same vibe that, I don't know if you remember my CD, Beat Street.
Mm-hmm. Sure do. You kidding me?
I started that out as a garage band project. I invited David Palmer from Rod Stewart's band and Cliff Hugo from Ray Charles' band to come over. We set up and we just started playing.
In your garage?
In my garage. And this time we started in my garage, which is my studio, and I invited Nate Phillips from the Daz Band and Sergio Gonzalez, who's played with Jennifer Lopez. And we just started playing music, and that was the foundation for the CD. Yeah. I wanted real people playing real music and good songs and just a nice, you know, acoustic, funky, good-feeling record.
It makes a difference, doesn't it, when you got other people in front of you instead of, you know, emailing tracks and stuff back and forth?
I mean, when I look back over the records I've made, I always think, if there's one thing I could do differently, it would be replacing all of the machines with real people.
Yes. That would be good.
Yeah.
And I think you have the support here as well.
Yeah.
Well, you got some real people on this one, man. The roster is crazy.
It's my buddy.
Crazy. It's fun. Yeah.
I get by with a lot of help from my friends, I'll tell you that.
Yeah. I mean, listen to this. You got Brian Culbertson on here. You got Brandon Fields on here. You got Huges on here. You got Randy Jacobs, who has been on this stage. Dave Koz has been on here. Jeff Lorber. Goodness gracious, man. You got some great friends. Philippe Says, Freddie Washington.
Yes.
Freddie Washington?
Yeah.
Yeah, Freddie. Yeah, Freddie came
He's
over.
He's great.
Cool.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about your process then. Is that it, or is that how you typically write? I mean, get some people together, just start riffing a little bit
together,
or playing?
Or?
Well, that was for a few of the tunes. There's several tunes on there that I wrote myself. I just would go into the studio and just start writing, you know, at the end of the day. And
Do you know. Like write?
Nobody writes anymore. Nothing goes down on paper.
Okay.
You know, everything has evolved where there's
You start playing the trumpet and
I
you kind of go.
Playing, I put put it into record and start recording ideas, and then I build a track out from there. Or I might start with a groove, you know, or just
a groove,
a mood. I guess a mood comes first, then the groove, and the title comes last. Always comes last.
Okay. A groove and a mood and a title. Wow.
I don't know.
Glass of wine, relax, play a little music, have a little fun.
I wish I would have got an instrument and started playing, so I could like.
I can't see you. I'm going to have to take these off.
No. I really wish, Gary, did you take a musical instrument in Did you?
Yeah, I did. Well, my mom sang and played piano.
And you played guitar, right?
She taught me piano. So you know about. I took piano lessons and then taught myself guitar and a little bit.
Do you play piano?
I do. I think, and I would advise any young musician, any parent of a would-be musician.
Mm-hmm. Or even a not would-be.
Anybody. If you're going to play any musical instrument, piano or guitar, you need to learn a chordal instrument.
And I heard musical training helps you with math.
That's what I hear.
Are you not good at
that? I'm not proof of that.
I busted my bubble.
Put it this way. You don't want to sit next to me at a blackjack table. I hold the whole thing up.
Oh, yeah, I'm the same way, but wow.
How did you start?
Yeah.
Well, you know, and I'm sure we've talked about this, but it's a good story. But when I was 8 years old, it was time to start looking for an instrument. Back then, the grade school always had instruments that they would hand out, and they'd been played by every kid and slobbered on by everybody in the world.
Really?
But back
really?
Then, the germs were a little bit different.
Really? That's why you should go for the string instrument. Stay away from
always a safe bet, the string instrument. Stay away from clarinets especially. That's dangerous.
But they say if you got your own reed, you're okay.
Well, here's where I got around that. I was at home, and I was rummaging through the closet, as eight-year-olds do, and I found my brother's old trumpet, and he was a trumpet player, but he quit trumpet to play football, and then went off and got married, and he got a concussion with the football and everything. So you don't get many concussions playing trumpet.
Unless you're really doing it wrong.
Well, look, I'm good at reading defenses.
Yeah, so there you go.
So I found the trumpet in the closet, and I picked it up, put the mouthpiece in, and I could get a sound out of it. Now, anybody who's tried to play a trumpet, you know, it's not an easy thing. So I had a head start there. So I picked it up, and I just immediately fell in love with the sound of the instrument. Wow. And it was just such a simple, beautiful instrument. And it didn't hurt to have somebody like Herb Alpert be a huge star.
Oh,
man.
You know,
so true. Those are such great records, man. I mean, our house, that Christmas one, that was part of the part of the season. Maybe.
I heard A Taste of Honey so many times when I was a little girl from my dad, and he would walk around with his finger like this and go, and he would be pretending to play the trumpet.
Well,
and I said, "What the heck are you doing?"
Every dad in the world had that record because of the cover.
Oh. Yeah, man. Yeah, that's right. And every teenage boy grabbed that record.
You know it.
Wow.
How funny. I heard that was not. It wasn't whipped cream. It was shaving cream.
It was. I don't know. I wasn't there.
I read it. I wasn't there either, but I read it somewhere.
Oh, my gosh. Stop. We could continue down this road.
Yeah,
I know, and we won't. Go ahead.
Bring it back.
Bring it back.
Did your folks play?
My mom was a self-taught banjo player, piano player, and singer, and she was a smoker and had this wonderful, husky voice. And she was amazing because she knew the bridge to every one of those standards and the refrain, not just the chorus. So somebody would start, you know, one of those Nat King Cole's, like Stardust. She would know everything about it.
Is that how your brother got started? Was from your parents? Because it's your older brother, right?
Yeah, my older brother, yeah. And so he was the other musician. And then my younger brother is a trombone player, and he's a good trombone player. You know, and he leads a jazz band in Allentown, Pennsylvania. So he's a good guy. He's a good guy.
Nice. How are things in Allentown? When was the last time you were back? You're still back there, right?
I go back there quite a bit. You know, I just played a concert there. My father worked at the Bethlehem Steel Company, and he was in the mill, you know, and worked there. And
that's a real world, man.
And he retired, and there's a venue that they have set up. The city has funded a venue that the Bethlehem Steel is the backdrop.
Ooh.
And it's pretty majestic. I mean, it's this huge iron factory behind the stage, and they light it up and everything. And it's always an emotional thing for me because I go and, you know, I'm standing around. I always tell this story about, you know, when I was a kid, my dad worked in the mill and, you know, took the money that he made to buy me a trumpet and their lessons and all of that
stuff. Did you get to go down into the...
I did not take the tour. No. I want to take the tour. Every time I come in, it's like quick in, you know.
Right.
And I'll leave, but... It's tough, though, because everybody from high school comes to the show, and everybody comes up to me and is like, do you remember me?
And you're
Well, I got news for you. Everybody has that deal.
That's okay.
That's awful stuff.
One of my reunions coming up next weekend, so I'm like, ooh, great.
It's fun. It's amazing how many people, if I look at them long enough, it comes back to me, and there's some silly thing that we did, like throwing ice balls at a truck as it was passing by. You know.
And you go, oh, yeah, I remember that day.
No danger.
Didn't everybody do that?
Not here in California. I'm sorry.
It was a Pennsylvania wintertime thing to do.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry.
Missed that.
Okay.
Oh, God. Oh, I so don't miss that stuff.
Yeah, it was cold.
Yeah,
was
absolutely. Cold. I'm thrilled that it's interesting that, you know, to take a turn back to this to this genre from the vocal thing and the other. What was the thinking?
The Sings with Strings record was just an absolute. It was a work of passion for me. I mean, I grew up, like I said, listening to my mom, listening to standards. And so I grew up with Nat King Cole and Tony Bennett and Frank Sinatra and Perry Como and all those great, you know, singers. And so I went down that road and enjoyed it. And it's been fun. I have actually established a second career as a singer. I have a show that I do at performing arts centers called A Walk Down Broadway with Rick Braun. Ooh. And I tell anecdotes about, you know, all of those great songs written by Sammy Kahn and Julie Stein and Frank Lusser.
Good.
Yeah, I mean, Frank Lusser alone wrote 700 songs for the Great American Songbook. And most of them are hits.
Yeah. Hmm.
You know, most of them, you start a song and it's, yeah, I know that one. So that show I do across the country, and I've got a Chet Baker tribute that I'm still working on, and so. But I came back because this is my home.
Yeah, it
I
is.
Came back,
yeah,
and everybody has just received me so well. It's been 5 years since I had a contemporary jazz record out, and I'm so thrilled that it's being this well received.
Clearly, your home. That's why it's. Yeah.
And clearly,
it's
they want
one.
It because being number one. That
yeah,
you know
exactly.
obviously tells
exactly.
you something.
Yeah. Let's. We're going to take a little break here and come back and have you. Have you do a little what you do best, all right? If
okay.
you would, if you love Rick Braun here,
too.
We'll be back on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. Welcome back to Breakfast with Gary and Kelly, everybody, with Rick Braun is here. You probably saw that, huh?
We'll do a selfie next break.
Okay, next break.
Oh, and selfie? Nice.
Yeah.
See, she's all about that stuff.
Hey, I went on 5 social networks today promoting you.
I was on 2.
Pinterest,
there you go.
LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And
I boomed you out.
Right, exactly.
I boomed you out.
All right, enough. Will you play something for us, please, for the love of God?
Play?
What are we going to hear? Something from new?
I am going to play a song that that I wrote with Jeff Lorber, who is one of my dear friends.
Great player.
And stepped
unbelievable.
Up with two songs on the record. This is a song that's the funkiest song ever written in the entire universe.
There you go.
We love funk.
All right.
It's called Delta.
Rick Braun, everybody. Thank you.
pretty funky.
That was funky.
That was funky, wasn't
that
it?
That was pretty funky.
I believe you. That's pretty funky.
Ed Lorber knows how to
yes, he does. That's the guy to go to for funk. There's no question about it.
He's so good. Man, I call him up in the morning when I start. I always call him up first. I call Jeff. I go, Jeff, I'm starting a new project. The next 3 hours are filled with songs being sent to me. There's like 6 songs coming into my inbox. By 3 in the afternoon, I could have the bulk of the record done if I used all of them.
He's a machine. It's unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah, he's like the Neil Simon of jazz. He's
it's really true.
Writing every day.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Every day.
Crazy. Unbelievable.
God,
unbelievable.
We love you, Jeff.
Yeah, we do.
Hi,
yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. How about another one? What do you got?
What are we going to do? Let me look at my list. What do you got here?
This is my
end of the day. This was the first song I wrote by myself for the record.
Yeah.
Aside from the garage band approach, but I did still write it in the garage.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Make sure.
All right.
So
all
this
right.
is called Silk.
Woohoo!
Thank you. do it. You can do it, man.
I can do it.
Let me see. Oh, you are silk.
Nice. That's silk. Rick Braun. That's on here. We're going to take a break and come back. Stick around here. Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. It's terrific, right?
Water for you.
Oh, yeah. I need that. Definitely. Yeah. Cheers.
Yeah, salute. Salute. Sit down. And cheers to you and all. Welcome back to Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. We're just enjoying some morning vodka, so... What?
Hey, I want
I'm
some.
Sorry. Maybe that's just me. Sorry. Oh, my goodness. Rick Braun is here with us. We're thrilling to have him and the number one CD in the land right now. Can you feel it?
Can you talk about the cover? I mean, I'm always interested in the photography and the front of a CD cover.
That is fun stuff.
Look at that cover.
Yeah, look at that.
That is... Believe it or not, that is our babysitter.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, where did you...
Yeah.
Okay.
Christiane, you got away with
everybody,
that, huh?
Everybody says that.
Is there a backstory on this one?
There's a backstory that goes back about 29 years. And it goes back to Terry and Michael Paolo.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, sure. Yeah, who were dear friends of mine back in the day when Michael was playing with Al Jarreau. And... That is Melissa Paolo. That's their firstborn daughter.
Oh, really? No, wait, let me see.
And she's an actress, and she was walking the red carpet last night because she's in the Cameron Diaz movie, Sex Tape. She's in that movie.
Oh, how nice.
Yeah.
That's a talented family boy, huh?
Wow, yeah. I didn't know Michael Paolo had a kid that old.
He has two.
Holy moly.
And they are absolutely beautiful.
They are
stunningly beautiful, and I was so lucky to have Melissa on the cover because there's no way I could do that pose.
Well, yeah.
And there's no way I'd pay to see you do that either.
So was this shot inside a studio? And
it was.
Swing your hair, or how did you came up with this?
Yeah, I wanted energy, and I wanted silhouette. I wanted a silhouette energy, and Melissa thankfully agreed to do it. And, we had a great photographer, and my wife actually styled the shoot. She bought this suit for me.
Oh,
and,
did a good job.
So today when it came time to do the TV show, she said, "You're wearing the suit, aren't you?"
Of course I am.
I wouldn't wear anything else, dear.
Well, this
You're
is
a
wise
awesome. Man.
This is awesome.
No, it's really a great cover. I'm really happy with
it's
that.
Really
and
pretty.
Melissa is such a sweetheart. And of course she doesn't babysit for us anymore. The kids are older, but she's a star.
Look at the insides. I mean, the insides too. I mean, even the little details.
Yeah,
that
it's
go
a great
on.
Package.
It's a really good package.
Really
the songs, everything.
And then, because I was on tour with BWB, and Kirk Whalum always wears that scarf.
Oh yes, the scarf.
So I had to wear the scarf because in honor of my brother Kirk Whalum.
There you go.
Nice.
There you go.
There
Very nice.
How old were the kids now?
14 and 12. 14
wow.
and 12. My daughter's 14 and my son is 12. Yeah, it's exciting.
Going through the puberty age soon.
It's a really fantastic time.
Yeah, listen to you.
No, it really is. They're great. They're great kids.
They are.
Kids.
How can we talk a little bit about
the
deal that you have to, have to, but the challenge that you face with Emma and that she faces?
Well, we have Emma's special needs,
yeah.
And she's autistic. And she's high-functioning autistic. We're very blessed in that.
Yeah.
And she's just a fantastic girl. She's a fantastic girl, but there are challenges.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when she asks the same question 14 times in a row, and she knows the answer in the first place,
mm-hmm.
it can try a parent's patience.
Yeah.
And it's interesting, and the reason I don't mind talking about it, because a lot of parents who are going through this, there's a feeling a lot of times like you're on your own, and there's those moments where you just need a break.
Yeah.
And there are breaks available. Now, it's not widely advertised, but there are social agencies
mm-hmm.
that are available, and they don't make it readily accessible. You
right.
have to seek it out. But
mm-hmm.
we've managed to get services for Emma that are wonderful. She's had behaviorists come
mm-hmm.
into the house and help her with basic things like eating. Like eating and tying her shoes,
mm-hmm.
which,
and they have the skills to work with somebody
because they
know.
Absolutely. And we have become best friends, and Emma has become best friends with we have two of them. Every time we have a party, they're invited, and Emma is so close with them. But to give you an example of, these kids are almost supernatural
mm-hmm.
in what they can do. I have to say, one time I was going to a show, and I'm all dressed, and I'm ready to go out the door, and Emma says, "Daddy, don't wear that shirt." And I said, why, Emma? She said, because you wore it last year when you played this show. We've learned, no matter how...
Wow, that gave me chills.
No matter how crazy it may seem, when Emma says something, we take it seriously.
You listen.
She remembers everybody. She remembers your doctor. If you had a conversation with her, Philippe Sace would come over and say three words in French. He'll come over 6 months later, and she'll repeat the words in French back to you.
Oh,
wow.
But she has trouble
hitting
a ball. She has trouble throwing a ball. She has trouble, you know.
She doesn't.
There are concepts.
Yeah, that's true.
That. But on certain things, do not go up against her, okay? On the memory test, I'll lose every time.
How's it been for you as a father? I mean, it's obviously trying, but I'm pretty sure it's probably opened up your eyes a little bit more.
You know, I think it's the most amazing thing on the planet. And it wasn't like it was my idea.
Right.
You know, I mean, I met Christiana, who was an amazing woman. Mm-hmm. And the only reason we have, well, not the only reason, but one of the main reasons we have a happy, healthy family is because of her, and she is a rock.
Mm.
I go and come into town, and she just keeps the wheels on the machine, and she just keeps them going with a smile on her face, and whatever happens, she deals with it. And there are very few, you know what I mean? We were, you know, my mom always said, God will never give you more than you can handle.
Exactly.
And I'll tell you what, that woman can handle.
You're a very
she's
lucky
amazing.
Man.
She's amazing. You
know? You're a very lucky man, and she's a lucky woman.
Thank you.
To hear you talk about her like that, it just gives me.
Yeah.
Ooh, wow.
Yeah,
just amazing.
We're married now 17 years, and that's at least four normal marriages in the entertainment.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Exactly. Just in this musical format.
Exactly.
Wow.
Well, congratulations.
Thanks.
That's great. Talk about the New Year's Eve thing. I mean,
there's
a great...
Absolutely, and we're hoping to work something out so we can do... We talked before the show, I don't want to put it out.
We'll do a broadcast live there.
Yeah, well, we could do that.
We could do that. Absolutely, we could do that.
I have been hosting an event, and it's a New Year's Eve gala, and it's a benefit for autism.
Yeah.
And it's in a beautiful resort, the Star Pass Marriott, Tucson, Arizona. Ooh. Not that far from here.
No, it really isn't.
And
it's
5 hours.
Great golf course, tequila toasts at sunset.
Tequila?
I never partake in any of that, but
I will.
You know. I tried the tequila toast and my toaster shorted. So I don't even know what the hell that means. But
this year, and the tickets are going very, very fast this year. We have Peter White is my guest.
Ooh. Heard of that guy?
I know him.
And Richard Elliott is also my guest.
Know him.
And we have also Larry Braggs from Tower of Power.
Oh, really?
So we're going to do a little Tower of Power tribute as well.
Oh, sweet.
So please come to rickbraun.com or my Facebook fan page. Please like my fan page. And you can...
And this is a benefit concert for autism?
For autism, it's Autism Society.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Great. Absolutely it is.
Absolutely.
Do you have any knowledge on you know how things are progressing at all in terms of you know battling autism? I mean there has been some progress made, hasn't there?
Well, the best thing that can happen, and this was something that happened with us, is Emma was 3 years old, and there was we had her in preschool, and the teachers sent a note home saying we think there's something going on, and so we had LA Unified. For all the bad things said about LA Unified, it's the best place for Emma, and she's just having a great experience there. They sent out a team and evaluated her, and they came back with an autism. They said we're pretty sure she's autistic, and we were panicked, and we fought the diagnosis for a while. And
you didn't want to believe it?
I didn't want to believe it. It was too much.
Yeah.
It was just
3 years of age. I mean, you're kind of like
But I remember it because she had to stack some blocks, and I remember we had somebody helping us then, and everybody was trying to encourage her how to do it, and she just didn't get it, you know. Mm-hmm. And we were all looking around, okay, you know. But then we accepted it, and the smartest thing any parent can do who has a child that you're even questioning this is get the evaluation, and if the diagnosis is true, you embrace it because the school district will give you all kinds of benefits, all kinds of services. An early diagnosis is the best thing. Then you can take advantage of all of the programs that are out. There's a thing called the Regional Center that is not widely advertised, and that is publicly funded help for respite if your child is highly autistic and you just need to get away.
Yeah.
They will fund a professional to come in and allow you
a night or two
out a week, as well as behavioral help with your child.
And you really do need to do that. I mean, you have to just walk away from it. You got to get a break.
I mean, even the most patient person in the world has their limits.
Right.
You know,
for sure.
But as I said, man, Emma is absolutely a jewel, and I would not trade her in for all the money in the universe. Yeah. You know.
Is she musical at all?
She's an incredible free-form wild dancer.
Amen.
And there was a period where she was my biggest fan, and then she found Dave Cause, and all we would hear about that was Dave Cause.
Really?
And now, fortunately,
that damn Cause.
So Dave would come over and rub it in. He'd go, who's that you're listening to? So we would.
That's awesome.
Right now she's into Earth, Wind, and Fire, and that's a good thing.
Oh, God.
So
what's your son?
I tell you what, she's got great taste.
She's a great girl. She's a great girl.
What about your son?
Kyle is an outstanding athlete. He's a basketball player, and he's also a very talented musician. He learns things by ear.
He's good for him.
My ear, and we're constantly trying to teach him to read the music instead of learning by ear.
Yeah.
But it's not a bad problem to have. And he loves sitting down at the piano. The other day, I was gone. I was on the road. But Christiana, again, this is one of those cases where he had a pool party for all of his 12-year-old friends.
And there was
lots of bikini-wearing 12-year-old girls.
Oh, really?
She sent me a picture of Kyle playing the piano with all of these bikini girls.
Oh, no, man!
That's my boy!
There you go! Oh, my God. Amen to that. Who needs football?
I can see that as the next cover of your CD.
Oh, my God.
That would be a good cover.
Somehow, I think that might not be a good idea.
Oh, God. Yeah, right.
Wait a minute.
You may consult the attorneys first.
I have to think these things.
Yeah, exactly.
Sorry.
We're going to take a break and pull Kelly back in. And then we're going to come back and have Mr. Braun perform for us once again, please.
Yes.
Stick around here at Breakfast with Gary and Kelly.
Okay, when they're older, 18-year-olds.
Absolutely.
We'll be right with you.
Sorry.
We'll be right with you. We were just doing a selfie. I know, exactly. Exactly. This is, this is going fast. So.
Has it been an hour already?
Do you know Inagata Divina? We could stretch this out.
That's a big trumpet song, by the way.
Oh, yeah, right, exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
What are we going to hear?
This is the title cut, which I wrote this song with Philippe Sace.
Oh, he's wonderful, isn't he?
He's so great. And this has that four on the floor, good feeling thing going on. And I listened to some Trombone Shorty when I was working on this record. And I wanted to have, I'm playing valve trombone on this song on the record, but I'm not going to do that now because I can't. Trombone is not very sexy, you know.
Oh, well, you never know.
Like I'd know.
No, I couldn't work it out to. Never mind. But this is the title cut. It starts out the CD written with Philippe Sace, and it's called Can You Feel It?
Can You Feel It? Rick Braun, everybody. Thank you. I did.
I felt something.
Rick, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. So great to see you, man.
So great to see you. Congratulations on this great new CD. Can you feel it?
Yes.
Thanks for all of you guys for coming today, too. We appreciate it. We will catch you all next time on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. See you later. Oh!